Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Solutions training video on MoCA loss budgets. In this training, we'll look at MoCA and non-MoCA device losses, coaxial cable MoCA losses, and show how to calculate MoCA loss budgets. In this training, we won't be calculating upstream or downstream losses. When calculating in the field, you should always do those calculations as well. We'll be using 57 dB as the maximum MoCA loss budget, which is the standard for most cable operators. I'll be using typical losses in the following examples. Always check with your manufacturer for the actual losses. In this training, we'll be showing the MoCA losses through standard 1 GHz devices, as well as MoCA enhanced devices. We'll be using most of these devices shown here. First, we'll look at the 1 GHz non-MoCA devices. The following losses shown through non-MoCA devices are typical of what you may see in the field. This data was taken from field samples to show how MoCA frequencies may react and is not intended to be a specification. This data may vary from splitter to splitter. Always consult your equipment manufacturer for actual MoCA losses. Let's start with the insertion loss through 1 GHz two-way splitters. These splitters are rated up to 1 GHz, and a typical insertion loss is around 3.5 dB for standard cable TV frequencies. This would be from the input to output, or from the output to the input. The MoCA frequencies range from 1125 MHz to 1675 MHz. Even though they're above the rated range of the splitters, they will still pass the MoCA frequencies, but at a higher loss. Typically 1 to 4 more dB per two-way splitter is shown here. In this training, we'll be using three MoCA frequencies, 1125, 1375, and 1525 MHz. So a two-way splitter will typically lose 4.5 dB at 1125 MHz, 5.5 dB at 1375 MHz, and 8 dB at 1525 MHz. As mentioned before, this can and will vary from splitter to splitter. The losses I'll be using were gathered from field samplings. With MoCA, the other loss path that we need to take into account is the port-to-port isolation path. Since MoCA is an in-home network, the MoCA signals need to travel between output ports of the splitter. The port-to-port isolation for a two-way splitter is typically around 25 dB. In the loss budget calculation section, I'll be using these losses of each individual device in our examples. Here's the insertion loss for all the 1 GHz splitters we'll be using. And the port-to-port isolation. In many MDU applications, they use directional couplers to loop the signal from one room to the other. Here I'm showing the DC6, DC9, and DC12 losses. First is the insertion loss between the input to output port. Next, the insertion loss from the input to tap port. And last, the port-to-port isolation path from the output port to the tap port. Next, we'll look at the MoCA point of entry filter. The insertion loss at standard cable TV frequencies range from 0.5 dB to 1.5 dB. And at MoCA frequencies, they typically reduce it by 40 dB. This is typically enough to prevent interference to neighboring MoCA networks or from them interfering with yours. The one big advantage of the MoCA filter is it reflects the MoCA signal back into the MoCA network. The filter has a reflective loss of about 2 dB. So if you had 40 dBmV into the filter, it would lose 2 dB and reflect back into the MoCA network at 38 dBmV. Here I'm showing the two-way splitter we saw earlier with a port-to-port isolation loss of 25 dB. By adding a MoCA filter on the input, it now changes the MoCA signal path. It first goes through the insertion loss path from the output port to the input. Then the signal hits the MoCA filter and reflects back after losing 2 dB. It then goes through the insertion loss path from the input port to the other output port. If you add up the losses through these paths, we now have 11 dB of loss at 1125 MHz, 13 dB loss at 1375 MHz, and 18 dB loss at 1525 MHz. This is a big improvement compared to the 25 dB port-to-port isolation loss without the filter. In the examples later, I'll be using the MoCA filter on all the examples because of this improvement. MoCA filters should be used on every installation. Here I'm showing a one-output non-MoCA amplifier. The MoCA loss through this amplifier is extremely high due to the amplifier stage and the diplex filters. The MoCA signal is basically blocked. So if you have MoCA devices on the input side and the output side, they'll have a hard time communicating. Here's a non-MoCA multi-port data amplifier. As with the one-output amplifier, the MoCA loss between the output ports and the input port, or data ports, is extremely high due to the amplifier stage and diplex filters. MoCA loss between the output ports would be the same as with the standalone non-MoCA splitters. As mentioned before, the previous losses shown through non-MoCA devices are typical of what you may see in the field. This data was taken from field samples to show how MoCA frequencies may react and is not intended to be a specification. This data may vary from splitter to splitter. Always consult your equipment manufacturer for actual MoCA losses. Next, we'll look at some of the MoCA design devices. First are the MoCA splitters. They look similar to the standard 1 GHz devices. The external difference is on the label, which will indicate it includes MoCA frequencies up to 1675 MHz or beyond. They may also indicate MoCA on the label. With MoCA splitters, the actual MoCA losses are known for the insertion loss and the port-to-port isolation losses. They will not vary as with the non-MoCA devices. Your manufacturer can provide you with the actual specifications of your devices. There's also MoCA devices that have the MoCA point of entry filter built into them, such as splitters and ground blocks. For this two-way splitter with the built-in port of entry filter, the port-to-port isolation is 15 dB. The MoCA DOCSIS passive is designed for MoCA and DOCSIS devices. Through this device, the maximum MoCA loss between any two ports that communicate at MoCA frequencies is 28 dB. To learn more about this device, check out our website. I'll provide the link at the end of the training. This is one output MoCA bypass amplifier, which provides a MoCA path between the input port and the output port. This has 5 dB of loss at MoCA frequencies. Next is the multi-output MoCA data amplifier. Between any of the output ports or data port, there is 30 dB of loss at the MoCA frequencies. MoCA will not pass through the input port. Next, we'll look at the MoCA losses through the coaxial cable. Since the MoCA frequencies are higher than the standard cable frequencies, they will have more loss through the cable. Here are the losses you should expect at the MoCA frequencies for RG59 and RG6 cable. Now that we've covered the MoCA losses through individual devices, let's do some loss budget calculations through a few installation examples. In the following examples, I'll be using the term gateways and clients. The gateway is the main MoCA device, which has the tuners and or DVR and or a modem. Some other names for this might be the controller, DVR, TiVo. The client is the MoCA device that requests and receives content from the gateway. Some other names may be Mini or eBox. The intent of MoCA is that any MoCA device could communicate with any other MoCA device on the MoCA network. For these examples, I'll be showing the path between the gateway and one client. But the process to calculate the loss budget path between any other two MoCA devices will be the same. We'll be using 57 dB as a maximum loss budget. In this example, we'll be using a non-MoCA four-way splitter with a point of entry filter on the input. The loss path we'll be calculating is between the gateway and the client right below it. For from the gateway would go through 50 feet of RG6 cable. I'll be using 1125, 1375, and 1525 MHz for the MoCA loss frequencies. At each loss stage, I'll be showing the individual losses at each of the three frequencies, and then to the right of that, I'll show the total loss to that point in orange. Since we have a point of entry filter on the splitter input, the signal path goes through the output port to the input, losing the indicated insertion losses. It then hits the point of entry filter and reflects back to the input of the splitter, losing 2 dB. The signal then passes from the input to the other output port with the indicated insertion losses. It then passes through another 50 feet of RG6 cable to the client with the indicated losses. And the total losses are indicated in orange on the right. This will be the process we go through with each of the examples. At the end of each example, you may want to pause the video to study it further. In this example, we have a two-way splitter with a point of entry filter. One leg feeds the gateway, and the other leg feeds a three-way, which has three clients. The path we'll calculate is from the gateway to the bottom client. From the gateway, we go through 50 feet of RG6 cable. Take the insertion loss path from the output to the input of the two-way. The signal reflects off the point of entry filter, goes through the other insertion loss path, goes through 50 feet of cable, takes the insertion loss path of the three-way, then through another 50 feet of cable to the client. For the total loss budget, as indicated in orange by the client. So as long as we know the path that MoCA takes between the two devices of interest, we just add up the losses of each component in the path, and that's our total loss budget. In this example, we have a two-way with a point of entry filter. One leg feeds another two-way, feeding two clients. The other leg feeds a three-way, which feeds a gateway, a modem, and a client. We'll do a couple of loss paths for this example. First, we'll calculate from the gateway to the client off of the same three-way. First, we go through 25 feet of RG6 cable loss. Next, it goes through the port-to-port isolation path of the three-way, and then through 50 feet of RG6 cable. Add up all the losses, and we have the loss budget total as indicated in orange by the client. Next, we'll take a different path. We'll go from the gateway to the top client off of the two-way. We go through the cable loss, insertion loss of the three-way, another cable loss, insertion loss of the two-way, reflective loss of the PoE filter, insertion loss, cable loss, and another insertion loss, and the final cable loss. Add all these losses together, and we have the loss budget as indicated in orange by the client. So even though this path is more complicated than the last, as long as we know the path MoCA needs to take, we just add up the individual losses of each item that the signal passes through, and we have the total loss budget. It's just simple addition. In this example, we have a two-way with a point of entry filter. One leg feeds a DC9, which feeds two clients. The other leg feeds a two-way with a gateway and a client. First, we'll calculate the loss from the gateway to the client off of the same splitter. Pretty simple. Cable loss, port-to-port isolation loss, and cable loss. Add all three losses up for the total, as indicated in orange by the client. Next, we'll calculate the loss from the gateway to the client that's off the tap leg of the directional coupler. First, we go through the cable, through the insertion loss of the two-way, or cable loss, insertion loss, filter reflective loss, insertion loss, cable loss, insertion loss from the input to tap of the directional coupler, and the final cable loss. Add each loss up, and we have the total loss budget as indicated in orange by the client. This example is similar to what you may find in an MDU loop system where one room feeds another. We'll be calculating from the gateway to the top right client. First, we have the port-to-port isolation loss from the tap to the outport of the DC12. Next, cable loss, insertion loss of the first two-way, cable loss, insertion loss of the third two-way, and the last cable loss. Add each individual loss up for the total loss budget, as indicated in orange by the client. Next, we'll look at the loss budget using a DOCSIS passive device. This would be an application where all the outlets were home run to one location. We'll be calculating the loss from the gateway to the client on the top right. First, we have the cable loss, the DOCSIS passive device loss of 28 dB, and then the cable loss. Add them all up for the total loss as indicated in orange by the client. In this example, all of the ports from the gateway to any client would be about the same. The only difference would be the cable loss to each of the clients. Next, we'll look at the loss budget using a MoCA amplifier. This would be an application where all the outlets were home run to one location. We'll be calculating the loss from the gateway to the client on the bottom right. First, we have the cable loss, the MoCA amplifier loss of 30 dB, and then the final cable loss. Add them all up for the total loss budget, as indicated in orange by the client. In this example, as with the DOCSIS passive device, all of the paths from the gateway to any client would be about the same. The only difference would be the cable loss to each of the clients. In this last example, we'll use the MoCA bypass amplifier. This would be where MoCA devices would be both on the input and the output side of the amplifier. We'll be calculating the loss from the gateway to the client on the bottom right. First, we have the cable loss, insertion loss, reflective loss, insertion loss, cable loss, amplifier loss of 5 dB, insertion loss, and cable loss. Add each individual loss up for the total loss budget as indicated in orange by the client. In this training, we showed the MoCA and non-MoCA device losses, showed coaxial cable MoCA losses, and calculated the MoCA loss budgets. I hope this training helped you better understand the path that MoCA takes between devices and how to calculate the total loss budget. Thank you for attending this training on MoCA loss budget. For additional training topics, see our website at amphenolbroadband.com.